Hello and welcome to the Gate Boosted, your one-stop solution for all your competitive examinations. In our first video, we introduced our subject Geotechnical Engineering and came to know that it is the study of behavior of earth materials. And now, from this video onwards, we will be starting our very first chapter of soil mechanics. As civil engineers, we build different types of structure, and its behavior or its stability depends upon the soil upon which it rests. Further, the property of that soil is directly dependent upon its mode of formation. And hence, our very first chapter is Origin and Formation of Soils. But before we start our very first chapter, let's have a look at number of questions being asked in different competitive examinations. For past 35 years of GATE, we can see only 3 questions being asked from this topic. And this chapter was recently excluded from the syllabus of GATE. For past 25 years of ESE, we can see 6 questions being asked from this chapter. Similarly, 6 questions were asked for past 15 years of SSCJE. And these are the number of questions we will be solving in our next video. The questions asked from this topic is very basic. And losing an easy marks can cost your rank very dearly. Because hard question, a very few people attempts. But an easy question, everyone attempts. So without wasting much of your time, let's start our very first chapter, that is Origin and Formation of Soil. Soil, as defined by a father of modern geotechnics, Sir Tarjagi, is the accumulation of loose materials over the earth's surface, which is either formed due to the physical or chemical weathering of rocks or due to biological activities of organic matter over a longer duration of time. These processes of formation greatly affects the property of soil which is formed. So let's learn about these processes in detail. First of such process of formation of soil is physical weathering of rocks. As the name itself suggests, our parent rock will have to undergo some amount of physical forces or stresses due to various agencies like temperature, abrasion, splitting action of ice or root penetration of plants and trees. Due to variation in temperature, our parent rock tends to expand and contract. But not all the parts of rock undergo same amount of expansion and contraction. This leads to the development of tensile stresses. And these stresses leads to the formation of microcracks inside the rock. These microcracks, with passage of time, breaks our parent rock into a coarser soil. Next is abrasion. Abrasion is the physical force in terms of rubbing or scraping. This rubbing or scraping can be felt by our parent rock due to moving wind, water or glacier. Next agency is splitting or wedging action of ice. Splitting or wedging action of ice refers to the abnormal behavior of water expanding its volume when it freezes. Water inside the microcracks expands its volume when it freezes, leading to the development of larger cracks. Last agency of physical weathering of rock is root penetration of plants and trees. The roots of plants and trees tends to develop into the exposed surface of the rock, leading to the development of cracks. In this type of weathering, the chemical or mineral composition of the soil formed is as same as to that of parent rock. It produces coarser soil material which are cohesionless or non-adhesive in nature. Some of the examples of soil formed due to physical weathering of rocks are gravel and sand. Moving on to our next type of weathering, that is chemical weathering of rocks, we can see that it can turn hard rock mineral into a soft and easily erodible one. It is mainly caused due to oxidation, hydration, carbonation and leaching. Oxidation occurs frequently to those rocks containing metal as their minerals. Oxygen from the atmosphere readily combines with the metal inside the rocks to form brittle metal oxides. It is similar to rusting in iron. Hydration is a common phenomenon in humid climates. where the water from the atmosphere reacts with the rock mineral to form a soft substance. Next is carbonation. Carbon dioxide from the atmosphere reacts with water to form weak carbonic acids. These carbonic acids react with the rock minerals like iron, magnesium, and sodium to form a new soft and cohesive material. Last is leaching. Rock also contains some water-soluble mineral, and these minerals get washed away by water and some weak organic acids, leaving behind a soft substance for us. In this type of weathering, the chemical and mineral composition of the soil formed is different from that to a parent rock. It produces finer soil material of cohesive nature. Rock containing silica as their mineral are known to be more resistant towards this type of weathering. Clay and silt are an example of soil formed due to chemical weathering of rocks. Coming back to our last process of formation of soil, we see that in this type of weathering, soils are formed due to biological decay of organic matter like leaves, trees, dead bodies, and organic waste of animals. This type of soil are also known as cumulus soils. These soils are extremely compressible, organic, and fibrous in nature, and hence its use is best avoided. Chemical and mineral composition of the soil formed is different from that of organic matter. Some of the examples of cumulus soil are peat, muck, and humus. Now, since we are familiar with different processes of formation of soil, let's jump into very basic classification of soil based upon origin, size, and transportation agencies. Most of the questions in different competitive examinations from this chapter are asked from this topic. But before we start classifying our soil, let's learn a bit about geological cycle. Geological cycle consists of four phases. First, the rock undergoes erosion. It is then transported and deposited to a new location. This shift disturbs the equilibrium of forces upon the earth plates and causes an upheaval to form. This upheaval again undergoes erosion and geological cycle is repeated. This small concept is being repeated again and again in different competitive examinations. So let's start classifying our soil one by one. Our very first classification is based upon origin. Based upon origin, our soil can be classified as residual or transported soil. As the name itself suggests, residual soils are the ones which remain at the place of their formation without getting transported. Whereas transported soil are the ones which get transported from the place of their origin by different agencies like wind, water, or glacier. Residual soils have much better engineering property when compared to transported soils. So that was our classification based upon origin. In our next classification, that is classification based upon size, we will be dealing with very basic classifications. We will be dealing with very detailed classification once we read about all the basic and index properties of soil. Coming to our second type of classification, that is based upon size, we see that our soil is generally classified as either coarse grain soil or fine grain soil. This classification is purely based upon the fact that our naked eyes cannot differentiate between the particles below the size of 0.075 mm. Our coarse grain soil can be classified into boulders, cobbles, gravel, and sand. Boulders are the rock fragment greater than 300 mm. Cobble, the size ranges from 80 to 300 mm. For gravel, the size ranges from 4.75 mm to 80 mm. For sand, the size ranges from 0.075 mm to 4.75 mm. For fine grain soils, it is classified into silt and clay. For silt, the size ranges from 0.002 mm to 0.075 mm. For clay, this size is less than 0.002 mm. Our next classification is based upon different transporting agencies like wind, water, gravity, or glacier. First is wind. Soil blown away by wind or air from one place to another is known as aeolian soil. For water, it can be either river, lake, or sea. For rivers, it is known to be alluvial soil, and it is alternate layers of sand, silt, and clay. It can be found from Assam in the east to Punjab in the west. For lakes, it is called to be lacustrine soil. And for the soil found in the seabed, it is known to be marine soil. If the transporting agency is glacier, it is known to be glacial deposit. And if the transporting agency is a mix of both glacier and melting water, it is known to be glaciofluvial soil. Soils are even transported under the action of gravity, and those soils are known as colluvial soil. This section is a favorite part for question setters. They keep asking same questions again and again, which we will be seeing in our next video. In our last point of this chapter, we will be discussing some important field names which a geotechnical engineer must be familiar with. First comes black cotton soil. It is a type of residual soil which is formed due to the chemical weathering of basalt. It contains high percentage of clay mineral montmorillonite, due to which it exhibits high amount of swelling and shrinkage. This type of soil can be found in central and southern part of India, and pile foundation is generally used for construction in this type of soil. Next is bentonite clay. It is also a residual soil which is formed due to chemical weathering of volcanic ash. It contains high amount of clay mineral montmorillonite, due to which it exhibits large amount of swelling and shrinkage. Its slurry is used as drilling mud for stabilizing the boreholes for pile foundation. Next term is warped clay. Warped clay is a type of lacustrine soil containing alternate layers of clay and silt. Next is indurated clay. Indurated clays are hardened clay which does not soften even under prolonged wetting. It is unlike any other clays. Next is marl. Marl is stiff marine clay formed due to the decomposition of dead bodies of aquatic plants and trees. It is slightly green in color. Next is loam. Loam is equal mixture of sand, silt, and clay. These type of soils are best for agricultural purposes. Coming to our next soil, that is loess, it is a type of aeolian soil, weakly cemented silt with calcium carbonate and montmorillonite. This type of soil is generally found in semi-arid and arid regions. Next is lateritic soil. It is formed out of basalt. It is soft when wet and hard when it dries. Its color is pink or red due to the presence of iron oxide. Last is talus. Talus is colluvial deposit or deposit made under the action of gravity. It can be found generally at the bottom of a cliff. Coming to our next field name, that is peak, it is fully decomposed vegetative matter. It is highly organic soil which is fibrous and highly compressible in nature. Humus is partly decomposed vegetative matter. And muck, on the other hand, is mixture of inorganic soil and organic matter. So that was the end of our very first chapter, origin and formation of soil. In our next video, we will be solving all the questions which have appeared in different competitive examinations. Don't forget to like and subscribe if this video was helpful for you.